5, Phil Wilson, and number 3, Tracy Shelton. West Virginia leads 9-7. The Mountaineers missed their first 5 shots, but have hit their last 3. And Jeff Warren, who does a lot of damage.
Steeler, not really jump shooter.
And a steal knocked away by Crudup. Jamal Coleman is open. And he delivers to give Missouri a 15-9 lead. Nice pass by Reggie Smith.
Comes out of my ears when I do that. What a leap by Coleman.
Jamal Coleman scores for Missouri to make it 17-9.
And another
comes to the floor. Leonard for 3. And a foul. Possible 4-point play coming up. Coleman, who can really leap. Peeler for 3. Hear that net snap as he pocked it through there. 8 points for Anthony Peeler. Point lead for the Mountaineers, who started slowly. Peeler with a nice pass into Crudup for the jump hook.
Anthony Peeler, for all his scoring, is the all-time assist leader at Missouri, and he showed you.
Rebounded by Peeler. Looks like he wants to go coast to coast. And does. And a foul on Marcellus Basie.
You can really see why the pro scouts like Anthony Peeler. Off the dribble, he just explodes at half court, sizes up the opposition, and then just blows by Leonard and Basie, not able to get there in time to help out. So just great activity off the dribble right here. Basie not able to get over in time to really do anything except commit the foul.
Peeler has 10 points. This may be remembered as the night the lights went out in Greensboro. Apparently we've had some sort of a power failure. There is a tornado watch in effect in this area, and I'm hoping this is not an omen, Dan. Dan, well, where are you? Dan.
I'm right here. We're in the dark as usual, Mel.
There's our score. The scoreboard works. Now the lights are slowly
coming back on.
Not enough to play, though.
Wow, the lights that are actually over the court have not yet come back on, and they look to me like they might be those mercury vapor lamps that take a while to come on. So even after you turn them on, we may be sitting here a while until the lights heat up.
So again, our situation, we have 3:27 remaining in the first half. West Virginia leads by 3. The lights have gone off, some sort of a power failure, and it will take them roughly 15 minutes to get the lights turned back on.
And it's been a game that has been up and down, each team having little streaks where they've played very well. West Virginia with the 3-point lead, and we talked about Anthony Peeler before the game, and certainly he's had a fine game so far. We also talked about Chris
of the year. But here's Leonard, who has killed Missouri with his outside shooting. Completely now. Missouri scoring in the dark. Somebody scored. Jeff Warren scored in the dark. I don't know if they're going to count the basket or not. This is one of the strangest things I've ever seen. I heard a loud explosion. The lights and the power went off. Missouri never quit playing. That old saying about not quitting till you hear the whistle. They did. They heard the thunder, but not the whistle, and kept right on playing.
And down the court they went, and they scored.
Does it count, though?
Of course it never counts when you score in the dark.
Mentioned earlier, first a tornado watch in effect, then a tornado warning. There's a severe storm going on outside. A lot of lightning and thunder and very heavy rainstorms, obviously affecting what's going on inside the Greensboro Coliseum.
What we delay.
Anthony Peeler with a strike inside to Jeff Warren. It was kind of interesting in the first half. Booker puts up a 3. A seesaw game so far. The lead changing hands several times. Nothing came back thinking they were going to watch another game and found this game still in the first half. Imagine what would go through their mind. We had 2 power failures in the first half.
That was Peeler with the jam. That was
the proof. I'm sorry. I knew you'd get a buzz out of that. Coleman off the glass to score. 50-40. Anthony Peeler, Javon Crudup, Jamal Coleman and Frazier in there. As Prudup scores, he has 11 points. And it's 54-46, so Missouri maintaining the 6-8 point lead. And a steal by Peeler. Peeler throws it down. He's got 20, and Missouri has opened up a 10-point lead, the biggest lead for either team.
West Virginia, really.
Prudup, though, and very active on the boards. 8 rebounds for Javon. Frazier takes it to the hole. We'll be continuing our broadcast of Basie. That cuts the lead to 9. Frazier goes hard to the basket. That counts, and a foul.
In this second half, Missouri is basically shredding the Mountaineer defense. There's nobody...
That one.
Peeler for 3. He's been all he was supposed to be in this game. 25...
10 seconds.
Booker with a baseline jumper.
Peeler not in the basketball game. You wonder who's going to step up for Missouri, and Booker with an off-balance tough shot with 5 seconds left on the shot clock does. If you don't get the steal right away, you've got to get the foul.
Oh, yes, a jam by Jamal Coleman, but it was the penetration of Melvin Booker that made that play possible.
Coleman now has 15 points. West Virginia pressing. They're going for the fouls. They miss it out top. Basie comes in and actually fouls Coleman across the head. Basie at 5'8", fouling Jamal Coleman.
Three. Tigers break the press. And Prudup is fouled by Lawrence Pollard. Oh, no. The lights go out for the third time. Oh. Can you believe this? In the first half, we had two outages. The delays total 45 minutes. We finally get the second half underway. We get down to the last minute and 39 seconds, and the lights go out for the third time.
And we know from experience that it will take approximately 20 to 25 minutes for these lights to come back on. And the problem is these are vapor lights, and so once they go out, they have to wait about 15 minutes until they cool down enough until they can turn them back on. And for West Virginia, this is just dragging out the agony.
I think the West Virginia players would agree with that analysis. They have to let the lights cool down, and then it takes, as Dan said, a period of time for them to heat back up.
Well, actually, I think what they're going to do is call the two coaches together. We do, as you can see, have some light in here. It's not real clear lighting, and they may decide that they're just going to finish the game in these lighting conditions.
Well, what would you do if you're Gale Catlett? You're down by 11. Would you agree to that? I'm sure Norm Stewart wouldn't care. If I'm Gale Catlett, I'm not sure I'm going to do that.
It's worth a try to ask him. I agree with you. If you're Gale Catlett, I don't think you do agree to that.
Of course, the way the Mountaineers have shot in the second
half. Might help.
Turn them all off. For those of you who may have joined us late, we've had some severe thunderstorms and a tornado hit 20 miles south of Greensboro earlier today. Twice in the first half, we had the delays, and now another one with a minute 39 left. And maybe Leslie Visser can fill us in on what's going on. Leslie?
Mel, you and Dan were right on the money. Jay Krauthammel, the committee member from the University of Syracuse, just offered both coaches the chance to play under these lighting conditions. Gale Catlett, as you predicted, said, no, that's not fair to anybody. Let's clear the floor. Mel?
All right, Leslie.
And as I said, let's to repeat what we have been told by the officials at the Greensboro Coliseum is these are vapor lights, and once they go out, it's going to take 10 to 15 minutes to get them back on again.
Thank you, Mr. Wizard. We'll be back.